Don't get me wrong, man. I'm really young, man.
You're turning.
You cannot sit up like and tell me that you got none, man. You may not have three or four, but you got one, man.
Oh, so good.
Flex raps so like a country
fucking
musician.
Mumbly.
Well, it's country grammar. It's got to be country-ish.
Yeah, okay. I got you.
Welcome in, everybody, to the Craft Beer Republic, where we always have two pairs. I am Greg. I am being joined by two pairs of short shorts. Flexi, what's happening?
Nothing much, man. Let's get a good show in. How about that?
Yeah, let's get a
let's
good show.
Let's do
going.
It.
Two pairs a good show's going. So we can get to stomping. And then joining us is the damn one who's now salty. Erica, what's happening over there with your name changes?
Well, you said let's do the damn thing, so I typed in the damn thing, and then I was putting the two together, and I erased it, because I didn't want to be like, well, anyways.
Kind of realized how it added up.
How it all kind of added up, so I'm salty. Yeah. Hey, everyone, what's up? That was a quick change.
Yeah, quick change. Erica's had a couple of double IPAs, and she's having one more.
Double IPAs suit her well.
Yes, they look good on her like some Air Force Ones. What can I say?
Change her name to Giggle Me a Beer.
Perfect.
That'd be a good one. That's a good one. You need to help my wife. My wife wants a beer Instagram, and she's like, I don't know what to do. I'm going to have her come talk to you.
Oh, yeah. And we have the same last name, Flex. We'd both be a beer.
Yeah, that'd be
Mr. and Mrs. A Beer.
That would be tight.
That'd be hilarious.
We'd be siblings. Yeah.
Right.
Yes, right. Yeah, yeah. Right. Right.
Anywho, so much to get to, so much stomping to do. Did some beer research. Erica ran into some beer celebs over the weekend. Deb sent us something that we need to discuss and complain about. Ludicrous Libation Law, some booze news. And hey, if there's a little bit of time left, we're going to get to Your Beer by Astrological Sign. Because why the fuck not?
Yeah, because that's a thing and everything's true, right?
Yeah, things are true.
As long as you found it on the internet, it's true.
Right, and I absolutely believe in that stuff. So, yeah, can't
I'm
wait.
So convinced. That's so convincing.
Yeah.
Great job, Greg.
Thanks. I really strapped on my acting shoes there. And boy, do I feel good about it.
Quit talking about your strap on and let's go.
Always. Gosh.
All right, let's strap on these Air Force Ones and get to some drinking over here. Oh, we're loving our beer, and we're all drinking the same beer, which is fantastic.
Woo! Say what?
We are drinking Patterns, a double IPA from Great Notion Brewing, 8.2%. You're welcome over there.
Holla.
4.01 on Untappd. Very respectable. From Great Notion, they say this double IPA unveils to us new and exciting forms from the patterns within. Brewed with Rowaka hops from a family farm in New Zealand, we're excited to bring you this special double IPA. Special indeed.
It is super special.
This you've had this before, Flex, and you were like, you got to try the patterns. And I waited for the show. This is my first taste.
Yeah, so I got to let you know, when I cracked this can, it says Rowaka hops have a very robust aroma to them.
Yeah.
And once you crack the can, you instantly smell it. And then pouring it out into the glass, it just emanates that so much more. But what I thought was kind of strange as looking up Rowaka hops, and a lot of things say citrus, orange, grapefruit, kumquats, sure, which are essentially, you know, baby oranges,
right,
in a nutshell. I got like some real floral dank aromas, and it was actually kind of reminiscent of like a really, really high-end gin, like juniper berry, florally kind of notes to it, and that just totally blew my mind.
That's interesting. You know, I'm not a big gin drinker, so to never come up with that, but I was having a hard time putting my finger on the schnoz. Like, I got some floral notes, and I was, you know, I was like, what is that smell? And you, maybe you nailed it. I'm not a gin drinker.
I hope I nailed it, because it's exactly what I smell when I drink a really, really nice gin.
You've got my stamp of you nailed it. You definitely nailed it.
I get gosh, well, thank you so much. I'm with you on the dank. You had me a dank, Flex. I love me some dank, and this is, it's there. So good.
Oh, it's delicious.
Yeah. Erica, where's your microphone?
Yeah, why are you far away again?
What? Oh, sorry. You had me a dank, Flex.
There we go.
Is that better?
I was like, what the? Yes. I was like,
that was so much better.
It was sticking straight up. I was like, it was looking at the ceiling.
It's supposed to do that. Oh, the microphone. Okay.
Yeah, it was like just letting it do its thing. I'm like, hey, everyone. Yeah, it
took the blue pill.
But yeah, the, I mean, the color on this one too, it's,
oh, it's gorgeous. I mean,
gorgeous,
this is like
a, what do you call it? Like a pale straw, yellow type deal.
Yeah, straw is a good term. For that.
Visually, just, this is what I want every hazy to look like.
Absolutely.
It almost this has so a sparkle good. To it. I mean, yeah. And the bubbles
I
are
think
tiny.
That's just alcohol talking.
Is that what it is?
Those beer goggles.
Whoop, there goes the microphone again.
Yeah, I mean, the on the tongue jobber, I get some of those floral notes, but I'm getting way more tropical than I did on the nose. It's kind of hides in there. You smell it and you get one thing, you taste it. It's very tropical. You get like the orange and the kumquat that you were talking about. And I don't know, maybe some like mango or something going on.
Yeah, tiny bubbles, well carbonated.
Just about everything you said is what's going on in
all the things are happening.
My mouth. Yes.
Oh, man.
Yeah. This is just, but huge thanks to Great Notion.
Yeah, thanks for the
session.
This is
patterns.
I have to be honest. When I go to Portland, because that's where a lot of my family is, you know, we'll hit up Great Notion. And I always try to go for like, the unusual sours and the blueberry, all these things. I never really thought of them as an IPA or all. Yeah. This is incredible.
What I really love about Great Notion is you go on their new app that they had sent out or they released. And they say straight up on the app, IPAs, sours, and like gourmet stouts or something like that. But it's like they don't fuck around. They straight up tell you, look, we are brewing IPAs, sours, and stouts.
All the things.
And they don't give a shit, you know?
Those things. Right. All those things, yeah.
And I just think that's really great.
That is, and I'm with Erica. Like, whenever I saw them before, which was rare until I started shipping, it's like, oh, let me grab that sour, because that's what you always hear about is the sour. But this hazy is fucking chef's kiss over here. It's delicious. It's
beautiful. And, okay, on the algorithm scale, Flex?
Oh, 100% pass.
Oh, The can art is ridiculous.
I want this as a tattoo.
Right?
Oh, it's amazing. It's
just unreal.
Yeah.
Absolutely unreal.
Pretty fucking sweet.
Yeah.
8.2 ABV too.
Right in Flex's wheelhouse.
Just that is wheelhouse.
Yeah. Flex we discussed wheelhouse. It last week because he's a Hulk. You know, he really metabolizes quickly. And
he
does not
does.
Get drunk. Yeah. So, short shorts.
Purple shorts, still not in yet.
And I'm over here giggling like a little girl, and Flex is like, whatever, I could take 10 more of these.
Beer.
Like I said, same last name, I'm cool with it.
Yeah.
So the UPS guy or whoever delivered this was like, that box is ridiculous. Because
it came in a very decorated box.
The art on the box is amazing. So, okay. I was
almost more excited about the boxes.
It's amazing. I can't throw it out.
I don't know about you guys. The tape job on the box was like getting into Fort Knox. Like secured it.
Whole can of roll
they,
of tape
they know
on that
what
box.
The hell they're doing.
Needed a fucking machete to get through that thing.
And I think I know who packed it. So I was just, you know, I had a booth at a beer fest last weekend or a couple weekends ago. And I went to the Great Notion booth. I was like, oh my gosh, we got some beer from y'all. And this guy was like, oh yeah, we have a distro center here in Sacramento and I box that up for you. And then I was talking about the box, how cool it was. He's like, people get so like tripped out about these boxes. They'll come by and just ask for the boxes. And he's like, oh, we got thousands of them. They just give them away.
I believe that too. I still have mine stacked on top of each other down in my basement because I think I want to do something with them because they're
like
that
what?
Fucking
but
cool.
I don't know, but they're so cool. I can't throw
them like
out.
My wife's like, can I throw these away now? I was like, no, I feel like I need a picture and I don't know what it's going to be yet.
right.
She's like,
we
really
should each be one of the characters.
Of
we each need to be a character for Halloween or something. Yeah. Like,
that'd be funny.
That would be so funny. But so impressed with what they do. And I was not expecting that from this because I thought they were just a sour kind of thing. But Good
Did
work.
Did you try other beers at the festival?
Yes. So they were pouring the ripe, which I got some cans of the ripe, so I didn't go for that. There was like a peaches and something sour, and it was ridiculous. It was amazing.
Yeah.
So yeah, that was great.
Nice.
Good job,
Brandon. Good breweries to report about from the festival?
So kind of how it goes down, especially at this festival, because it was like steady, but not so busy that I needed my friends to be right next to me because I could handle the booth, is they just start like stacking the cups. They go and get more and they stack them. They're like, oh, this was a Martin. Yeah. This was a bit. And they're just sitting there. So I'm like drinking them while they're going and filling up my cup. I don't remember what half the beers were, but they were pretty good. I mean, like I said, it's like the job that you can drink and work and, you know, whatever. Hopefully the tail looks right.
At a, was like Surf and Suds almost a year ago, and Wiley from the Booze League, they had a booth, and Wiley got us in, and Coley was working the booth. So we'd go like drink a beer, and then we'd come back around like, you guys need fills, and we grab their glasses and go fill them up, and then go drink a beer like, you guys ready for more beer? So we just kept dropping beers off at their booth, and they didn't have to.
It's perfect. They're so lined up. And then the hospital had like rented out the entire zoo for like the employees, so Sterling took the kids. And I didn't think I'd make it in time. Huh? McDreamy.
Okay.
Oh, sorry. McDreamy took the kids.
I didn't know he had a real name.
I forgot. Excuse me. And I didn't think I'd make it in time, but I went over there after drinking the beers, and I got to even go to the zoo afterwards.
Fucking love zoos.
Yeah, it was a good day. Yeah, it was a good day. But I don't know what any of those beers were. Today, it was a good day. It was good.
That sounds like an awesome weekend.
Pretty fabulous. And we smoked some meats the next day.
Oh, meats.
Was not expecting meats.
I thought that was going somewhere else. We smoked some weed the next day.
Oh.
And then Dr. McDreamy went in for surgery.
No, that would absolutely never happen. But no, meats. M-E-A-T for the record, gentlemen.
Got it.
Thank you.
Nice. That's a fucking killer weekend right there.
It was a killer weekend. It's perfect.
Mine was not nearly as good, but I did do some research. We stopped in at, talked about this a few weeks ago, had one of their beers on the show, Eureka Brewing. Mm-hmm. Their new satellite tap room by us, had a few more of their beers, fucking chugged some more Pog Tart because it's delicious.
Oh, that sounds so
and,
good.
Oh, it's so good. They do such a good job. It's like that perfect, it's tart, not sour. Got the Pog flavors in it.
Love that Pog.
So good. That's my favorite fruit combo of like all time.
Really? Of all time. That's crazy.
It's amazing though. And my kids won't drink Pog. I'm like, we went to Hawaii. I'm like, drink Pog. And they're like, this isn't good.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Pog, something's wrong with them.
Hawaii, I was 20 when we went to Hawaii. First time I ever had Pog. And then I came back. I was like, I need to find Pog. And like, back then, nobody had Pog anything, and now like every other beer has Pog in it, which is great because I don't want to drink juice. I want to drink beer.
Yeah, so, exactly.
Now I'm just hoping everybody listening knows what Pog is.
Oh, passion, orange, and guava juice.
Thank you.
Sorry.
And it's here delicious. We are, being insiders.
Yeah. So did that, went to Eureka, then we went over to Bottle and Pint where our friend Spencer works, and we're talking to him. He's also one of the brewers at Made West, and he's talking about some upcoming beers. Speaking of Pog, they're making a Pog beer as well. So he's going to try and get some over for some research.
And their pale ales to die for.
Oh, best pale ale around. And they're hazy. I say it all the time. The best continually made hazy IPA in Ventura County. Boom.
Get it.
Mic drop.
Yeah.
Gut it and switch the laces.
And that's pretty much it for me. You guys been joining any football recently?
You know, loving week two, did not love week one. Mm-hmm. But I've been finding myself staying up, you know, late Thursday nights now and late Sunday nights now and late Monday nights now because I'm just so happy that it's back.
Yeah. Last week was a rough week for me. My two quarterbacks in my fantasy league, Dak Prescott, Trey Lance.
Yikes.
Yeah. So no more quarterbacks in my fantasy.
I did go all in one league on Trey Lance. I did not have another quarterback on my roster.
Uh-huh.
Quickly got one. So that was good.
Yeah. So now I've picked up, and I hate to say this out loud, I've picked up Derek Carr.
Yeah.
But he'll probably get injured.
Okay. He's got Devontae Raiders. Adams. He'll be all right.
He does. If anybody wants a quarterback to have a shit season or probably to like miss the rest of the season, just let me know. I'll put him on my team. I apparently have the touch this year. So You mad at Tom Brady? Let me pick up Tom Brady. You'll be good.
You know what? Can I just tell you right now, that is my curse with Milwaukee Brewers players, right? So in the entire years of me buying jerseys or like player shirts or anything like that, every time I have gotten that, something horrible has happened to that player. And this year, sorry, now Padres fans, but it was Josh Hader. I bought a Madres. Josh Hader jersey. Madres. Sorry. Yeah. Thanks, Chu. I bought a Josh Hader jersey this year, and he blew like 5 saves in a row. The Brewers traded him, and then he blew like 6 or 7 saves in a row for the Padres or something like that. So it's just...
He's rolling.
Yeah.
At least he's consistent.
Yeah, that's a good way to look at it.
Yeah, he's consistent.
He got really nice hair. And
yeah. Somebody, my wife is a big A's fan. She's from the Bay Area. She's an A's fan. Luckily, she's not a Giants fan. That's why we were married.
Yeah, that would be gross.
Yeah. Oof. And so there was a player on the team one year. They picked up a player that had the same last name as her. So she's like, oh, I want that jersey. Same last name, obviously. And so like, I got it for her. And as soon as we bought it, he was traded. Like, well, that was quick.
Great.
It's still cool to have that jersey.
Yeah.
It's still cool because it's your last name. So.
Yeah.
Is it AB? Because that's the best last name ever. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it is.
Now I need to get a jersey with that on my on the back.
On the front, it should say Flex Me, and on the back, AB.
Absolutely.
That's Team awesome. Flex Me.
A Brewers jersey with Flex Me a beer on the back would actually be pretty sick.
That'd be dope. You and the Duke of Drinkability need your Instagram handles on your
jerseys. Yes!
That would be tight.
That'd be a lot of characters for him, though.
Yeah, but he did take out the, so he's just Duke of Drinkability, so it's a little less.
Oh. Okay, still a lot. Yeah.
No, it's a lot. You're absolutely right. Yeah.
But worth it.
Great name, though.
Yeah, totally. Totally.
Such a great name.
Yeah. Well, speaking of football, our friend Deb was watching some foosball the other day. And she sent me a video because a commercial came on, and this is, it was for a car parts commercial, and this is what it was.
Whether you're restoring or modifying your classic, Original Parts Group is the GM parts provider of choice. Offering high-quality, industry-leading parts, the OPGI team is here to support you from installation to performance.
Motherfuckers.
Freaking with exceptional imposter. Service,
price match guarantee, it's still and going shipping, on. You can feel confident in your project from start to finish.
Anyway, that's enough of that.
Wow.
Down with OPG. Okay. yeah, I was like, God damn. So I looked it up. I was like, who was using it first? They were.
Oh.
Sad. Motherfuckers.
Yeah, that's what happens when you buy songs from Song Libraries. Somebody might get to it first.
Deb is so smart, though, because she knew it had to do with vehicular cars. Something yeah. or other.
I mean, but not trucks. I was really disappointed to find out it was about car. Like GM hot rods and not Ford trucks.
Right. But still, girl's smart.
Right. Do you need a cat-back exhaust for your 69 GT? Come love to whatever the fuck that website was.
Love me some Deb truck commercial impressions.
Oh, man. Love me some Deb in general.
Yeah, her car impressions are kind of the best.
She just gets so into it. She's so passionate.
Yeah. She's passionate about her Ford trucks.
I just hope she's super proud of it too, because she should be.
She should be. We need. I was gonna have her on the show, but her and intern Brian are in Denver right now. Those motherfuckers,
selfish assholes.
Good for them. I'm so them,
jealous.
Though.
I know. Good for them. But also, they went to Bierstadt Lagerhaus, and I'm so jealous.
That's that impressive. Place
is amazing.
You know what? That's okay, everyone, because we're all going to Denver for GABF next year.
Yeah, we're riding that neck notch coattail.
Next year. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah,
next year, 2023, October ish. Yeah.
We need the VIP passes from Neck Nosh.
Oh, I might have a booth there. Come on, let's see. I'm just finishing up the order I made for them. I'm so excited, but I'm nervous.
Can you just picture Flex and I walking around with the pass like Wayne's World?
Yeah. Oh, totally. VIP. Neck Nosh.
Just showing everybody's face.
CBR.
Neck Nosh. I'll work your booth. Give me like a sleeveless Neck Nosh shirt, and I'll work the booth.
Snap.
Oh, how about some short Neck Nosh booty shorts?
They better be green. Oh, yes. Make it happen. You're there.
Just says Neck Nosh across his ass.
Yeah. And I'd wear them too.
On the application.
Neck Nosh the hell out of me. I'm gonna work the booth for free.
Yep.
Mr. A Beer. First name,
it's gonna be
flex
amazing.
Me.
Oh, you're in. Totally.
Oh, this is going to be so good.
You might be the primary applicant, just so I can get in. Thank you.
You know,
in advance.
We were talking last week about how we're very inclusive. We went from talking about clean balls to Beavertown. Well, yeah. I think this is another instance of how inclusive we are. We're not having the typical female model in front of the Necknosh booth. We're having fucking tree trunks over here with the shorty 100%. Shorts and his guns flashing.
Oh, man, we will sell so many. Because if you stand in front of that
I'm
booth,
buy
people
some.
Flock. Oh, yes. People.
I'm super. Where do I apply?
Yeah, I'm
very, very interested.
Don't worry. I'll CC you on the email. You're going to be the applicant. We got this.
I got some references.
Perfect.
Do you need a letter of rec? To whom it may concern, our friend, Mr. Abir, is highly qualified. If you have not seen him in his booty shorts, especially the green ones, they are fantastic.
Oh, my goodness.
My face actually hurts. You guys are so stupid.
It's perfect.
I just like the Mr. Abir part. That's, yeah.
It's going to catch on, too.
It's
going
like
to
be
already,
like apricot or so. Apricot. Because is it a beer or a beer?
Mm.
That's for another episode, I think. But I want you to let it simmer for a bit because we need to figure that out. But
I feel like if it's my last name, I would like it to be a beer.
Well, heart you
a.
Know what?
Yeah.
It's you and it's yours and you get to claim it. So
always the heart A, Greg. Always.
nothing okay. Soft over there, that's for sure.
No.
You're welcome, everybody.
We got it.
I feel like it's time to move on. Sorry, go ahead.
That's it.
Were you going to dig us out of this or do I need to?
I'm just along for the ride.
I'm done. I can't breathe. I'm done.
Oh, Mike's going. It's insane. All right. Let me dig us out of this hole. Let's do a little ludicrous libation law. This one comes from Iowa, a place I have no intention of visiting.
Okay. The largest truck stop in the world in Iowa.
Oh, well, in that case, I'm still not going to visit. It's perfect.
I don't know.
Just four trucks. Sorry. Deb might stop. In Iowa, an owner of a venue that sells alcohol cannot legally have a drink after closing for business. And this also applies to all employees.
So after closing for business.
No shift, no work beers?
No work beers, no shifties. What do you?
Interesting.
Why work at an alcohol
shop? Yeah, well, why are you working there? Yeah,
but that's after closing.
Erica nailed it. It's after closing. Who cares?
Jeez, that's almost as bad as New Jersey.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Wow.
Nothing is ever as bad as New Jersey.
I feel like every ludicrous libation law ever could just be New Jersey now.
Yeah.
Just come up with a new segment. How can New Jersey be shittier? Well,
the answer is they can't. So, They've hit rock bottom, but yeah, we should have a segment called "Hey Joyzy, fuck you."
I'm not even gonna start this.
And then you can hear our accents that start somewhere and end in Boston.
Come on, Flex. Bring it on.
At some point, it sounds Cuban. It's
nah. I feel like mine starts Long Island, and then I think I'm like Boston, and then it just stays Long Island. And
you know, at some points, I can feel like my accent is Boston. And then I talk to Beer Girl Melissa, and I'm like, "Oh no, it sounds just like her.
It sounds
very
just
much New York.
Like her.
Yeah,
it's very
not
New
Boston
York.
At all."
And that's why Finland loves us. They cannot tell the difference. And there it is.
Yep.
No clue.
They're like, "We don't know.
We don't know. They nailed it.
Yeah.
Good job.
Yeah. They're just like, these guys are dumb. We laugh at them because they're
and
stupid.
Greg,
like,
yeah, he's so articulate. Good job. It's perfect.
Yeah. I hope they're not trying to learn English from me. That'd be the worst idea. Ever.
Or should they be? I feel like they really should.
They're just walking around like, yeah, I'm drinking the blue of the beer. I'm like, huh? You learned English from Greg. Sorry, it wasn't even funny. let's talk beer stuff. Instead of, I sound like Busta Rhymes. Anyways, sorry, Chew.
Sorry, not sorry.
Anyways, draft beer sales are up 21% for NFL's opening weekend over last year.
Why do you think that is?
I think because people are more comfortable going out to bars.
Agreed.
Okay.
I'm with you. Okay.
Either more comfortable or they're just tired of not going out to bars. One or the other.
Same. Yeah.
Both?
Yeah. Little A, little B.
Yeah.
So, sure.
Good job, everybody. The consumer price index, for some bad news, for beer at home, so to-go beers, was up 4.9% in August. Fuck you, inflation.
Yeah, it's really obnoxious right now.
Mm-hmm.
And by right now, I mean like the last
eight months. Yeah, 8 months.
Just horrible.
My favorite was a couple months ago. They're like, inflation has stopped. It's like, okay, that's the wrong way to say it. It stopped growing. It's now evened out as bullshit.
I was going to say, my favorite was that inflation was up like 8% and they say the average is like 2. And I'm just like, oh, yeah, that's
super.
Go big or go home.
Yeah. Thanks, COVID. Fucking supply chain.
Still got our priorities. We're drinking.
Well, the good news is I know how to make beer. So if it gets down to it,
we'll just
make our own. You know?
There you go.
And the whole CO2 shortage, just do it old school. You could carb by adding sugar to the finished beer and it'll carb itself. And
okay.
We'll be drunk over here. Don't worry. That's the bottom line.
See what happens.
I'm not
worried.
I
have a few explosions in the process, but it's all right.
I've only had one explode so far.
That's good.
I'm going to be FaceTiming Greg. Am I doing this right? Am I doing this right? How do I make beer?
New, right? Oh, beer. Oh, beer.
Beer. Beer, beer, beer. Beer, beer, beer. Beer.
Gotcha.
The other stuff he pays for. It's fine.
Yeah. I was going to say. I know how you two work.
Yeah. Quickly moving on. The seven best, and I was so glad to see this, was called the seven best India Pale Lagers as opposed to cold IPAs.
Is this on Untappd?
This is from Untappd. The one good thing Untappd
I laughed at
done.
This one just based on the India Pale Lager.
Yeah, well, I'm glad it was India Pale Lager, not cold IPA. So the seven best of 2022. Number seven, Goose Island, Kentucky. What? No, just kidding. Number seven, Avatar.
Totally fucking got me.
Yeah. It's like, what?
I was lost.
Sorry, bad joke. Number seven, Avatar from Oedipus Brewing. Number six, oh, fuck. Balthazar from Finland. Stop listening.
From Finland.
Pivovara Medvigrid.
Oh.
Nailed it.
Yeah. Got it for sure. Number five, Moses 6 from Zuid Craft. Number four, Prototype. What are these breweries?
Why are these all? Yeah.
From Curveter Krita Brewery? Fucking A. number three,
I could just listen to you pronounce these all day long.
Yeah.
Maybe I should have pre-read this. Number three, Pride and Parquet from Jack's Abbey Craft Lagers. Number two, Hoponius Union from Jack's Abbey Craft Lagers. And number one, Maintains and Shapes from Revolution Brewing Company.
That's a lot of foreign words for me.
You're telling me.
We need to load up the shaggin' wagon and do our European tour.
Well, I haven't had any of those beers, but I assume they're really good.
I bet.
Totally. They're great cold IPLs.
Nothing from Untappd is inaccurate or a poor representation. So that had to be like, yeah.
Yeah,
it's legit.
It's always the best version of that style, and yeah,
absolutely, sure, and all the most intelligent people putting it together. Yes,
yeah, abso-fucking-lutely. Nailed it. all right, let's talk about your beer by sign, Erica. What's your astrological sign?
You would never guess this because I don't think I fit my sign.
And
I'm a Scorpio.
Anything about
my
signs.
God?
But come on, everybody knows what a Scorpio is supposed to be, right? Like dark,
scorpion,
green.
Right? You're a scorpion,
Scorpio. Yeah.
Scorpion.
Scorpio.
Oh.
Homie.
Like, Razor? Scorpio?
I don't know. I'm a Scorpio.
Well, spoiler alert, these are all crap beers. But you might have one of the best ones on the list, Erica. You, as a Scorpio, are a Guinness.
Okay. That's the best? That's the best one?
Well, it gets worse from here. Flex, what's your sign?
The 69 one.
What is
Leo?
That?
No.
This is the Cancer. It's
cancer?
Like 69.
Okay.
Yeah.
I don't know what
it is. It's like two little spermies, isn't it? The kind of like bloop, bloop, bloop.
And no, inflect, it's absolutely spermies.
Right?
Stop saying spermies.
Bloop, bloop, bloop.
Mr. A-Beer into spermies. No. Cancer. Yeah, see, this is where it gets significantly worse. Your beer is Blue Moon.
Gross. Oh. That is literally my least favorite beer.
It is
like on the planet
with a slice 100%. Of orange, baby. All right.
Ooh, this is probably my least favorite beer, and it's my beer as a Leo. Corona.
Oh, gross.
Wow, you guys.
If I'm drinking cheap Mexican beer, Corona is last on the list. I'm going like Pacifico or Dos Equis or
Modelo. I tell you what, I'd not still Corona. Rather have a Corona over a Blue Moon.
And I would rather have a Blue Moon and a Corona over a Guinness. Honestly, I'm not a real thick beer drinker. So I think that this is like your nemesis beer is what this really is. And the list was wrong.
It sounds like.
And yeah, what a horrible list.
Just because. Yeah. No.
Well, here, I'll run through them real quick. Aries is a Modelo. Taurus.
Ooh.
I could. Taurus
is a Miller High Life.
Oh.
Not bad. Yeah. Love me some High Life.
Gemini Budweiser.
Gross.
Of course, Cancer Blue Moon and Leo Corona. Virgo Michelob Ultra.
Cutting those carbs.
Yeah. Libra PBR.
Classic. Virgo,
of course, Guinness. Sagittarius Sapporo, which I'll drink with some sushi.
Yeah, that's not bad.
Yeah. Actually, this is probably the best beer right here. Capricorn. If you know any Capricorns out there, Yingling.
I've never had one.
It's like actually craft.
Huh. They merged with more with Coors. It's
great, but then, I think it's technical.
Yeah, I don't know anymore. And then Aquarius, Stella, Pisces, Heineken, and that's it.
Those are gross.
Yeah.
Wow.
Capricorn wins for sure.
And Untappd came up with this list?
Oh, I'm thinking the Modelo.
This was not Untappd.
Oh, this is not.
Oh, Modelo better than Yingling?
I love me some Modelo.
If I'm going
Mexican beer, I think my top is probably Dos. No, Dos Equis. Pacifico. One or the other. Dos Equis Pacifico, somewhere in there.
Oh, we all disagree. Yingling. So,
yeah. But no matter what it is, it's not Corona.
Absolutely I have to not. Say, guilty pleasure beer, because you never asked me that question because you kind of moved from that question when I came around, is a Corona Light. Because I'm just saying, I hope you still have me back, Greg. It's a Corona Light in Mexico. Like, I'm going to Cabo in December.
Tecate Light. If you're in Mexico, you drink Tecate Light.
Okay, I'll do that too.
Do you think it would sound weird if we just take Erica's track out of this entire show?
Yes.
Damn it.
110%.
After that answer, I just don't know how we can move on from there.
You assholes.
Were you listening?
Oh, hey. Hello. I'm still here. I'm just saying.
Really? Corona Light?
So many good memories.
Corona Light is better than Corona.
Is it? I don't know if I've had a Corona Light.
It's way less skunky.
12 for like $12 in Mexico on ice with like dead cockroaches in there. I mean, it's just that memory. That's the same trip I came back with the Montezuma's Revenge. I mean, there's just so many memories.
Yeah. We've talked about our revenges.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. It's so many memories. It's just, you know, when you're broke as hell and you just need some cheap beer.
We got it on the honeymoon, the Montezuma.
Yeah.
Right?
It was great.
When I was in Mexico, I was drinking that.
So great. So great.
Nothing will help you lose weight like some Montezuma's Revenge.
Right? I dropped like 15 pounds. Yeah. It's perfect.
I gained it all back once it stopped. But for that week, I was looking fucking great.
So I'll take your Corona. That's what counts. Which one would you take, Flex, out of the three of us?
Guinness.
It's a real Sophie's choice, huh?
That is a tough one.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
I TP for my
bunghole.
Yeah. Here's the thing. I don't like Guinness. I think I would also take the Guinness, and I don't even like it.
I don't like Guinness
either.
Winner,
apparently. Okay.
Yeah.
I'll take the Corona.
My story about Guinness, I've never actually had a Guinness before until my best friend came up last summer for my birthday. And he likes Guinness, so I bought him some. And there was one left in the fridge after he left. He absolutely loves Guinness. He just went to some Irish fest up where he lives, and he basically just drank nothing but Guinness for two whole days.
Okay.
Smitty's is better.
Guinness in the summer sounds like torture.
So,
I mean,
I had one left in my fridge, and I was like, you know what? I'm going to drink it. My buddy loves it. I'm going to just drink the last can. And the entire time drinking it, I was thinking to myself that I can't understand why anybody likes it.
Yeah.
I'm just going to throw it out there. I don't get it.
Yeah.
And I've had it on tap at an Irish brewery where they properly mix. Because the proper Guinness mix is like, I think it's 75% nitro, 25% CO2. And there's a bar out here owned by an Irish dude, and he properly mixes it. And look, that's the best way to have it, but still, it's not my jam.
Still not.
No, good. I don't get. I will never understand the.
Yeah, I don't. Not for me. For me. Never was. Even when I drink shit beer, like, it just was never my thing.
Oof, give me the Corona with the cockroaches, the cucarachas. I'm happy.
Lime and a cockroach.
Yeah, I want the cucarachas.
Yeah.
Unreal.
Yeah. Well, we will end it on this one. Teacher drives drunk, gets into crash on the way to school. This is not in Florida. This was in Kentucky.
That is shocking.
I totally expected this to be Florida. According to an arrest citation, a deputy was called to Girard County High School on Tuesday morning for a report about a teacher that had been involved in a crash and was suspected of drinking. The deputy said they saw 35-year-old Chelsea Denny drive into the Girard County High School parking lot with damage to her vehicle. Denny told the deputy that she had... What's a good excuse for crashing into a car? Anybody? Have you got a good
one? A spider drop in front of her.
Okay.
That's cool. Very good. I had... Quick story on that. I've had spider eggs in my car hatch, like in the roof of my car while I'm driving down to Chicago.
Dead. Well,
yeah.
Burn that. That was a wreck. I don't know. I would say she was drinking hot soup out of the can.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, Denny told the deputy she had dodged a cat on the way to work, which caused her to wreck into another car. But of course, why would we stop after wrecking into another car? We gotta get to work. When the deputy talked to Denny, they said she had slurred speech and smelled of alcohol. The deputy had Denny do a field sobriety test, which the teacher failed. Don't forget, this was done at the school. The citation said Denny had a blood alcohol level of 0.23. That was pretty fucking dead on. 2.22.
Damn.
Wow.
Yeah.
That was good.
2.22.
That's a lot.
Almost three times.
That's a lot.
Denny was taken into custody on charge of operating a motor vehicle under the influence of alcohol. I don't know why she wasn't taken into custody for being hammered at a fucking school.
Yeah, seriously. That's obnoxious.
Denny should have taken a turn and gone to Denny's, got herself some pancakes and eggs before she went to work.
Nothing will sober you up like that Grand Slam.
Grand Slam, girl.
Do you remember when you used to be able to get the holographic Ken Griffey Jr. card? When you ordered the Grand Slam, that was the shit.
Yeah. I can't believe I remember that, but yes, that's hilarious.
Amazing. Oh,
thanks, Denny's. Thanks for sobering us up.
Thanks for the memories.
Yeah. I was going to sing, but I won't. Oh man, we have had some double IPAs today. I think it is time we do ourselves a favor and we hit some music. As we do that, we'll say hi to Vanessa.
Hi, Vanessa. Hi, Vanessa.
Hey, friend.
We'll say check us out on the socials at Crappy Republic, at Flex Me A Beer, _ in between. Go follow Mr. A Beer, and then go follow Miss A Beer at NeckNosh LLC, also _ in between, necknosh.com. Find us at craftbeerrepublic.com, as well as 805-538-BEER-2337. I do believe that is everything. Thanks to Great Notion for the tasty beers tonight. I hope everyone is staying very well hydrated.
And on that note,
good night, everybody.